In this video, I will demonstrate the process of defining a new customer in the Priority system. From the Marketing and Sales menu item, we're going to go to Customers and open a customer record. Here we'll put in the customer name, and as soon as we click Enter, the number column is filled in temporarily, beginning with a value beginning with T, which indicates a potential customer. We can record such customers in marketing campaigns, price quotations, and even sales orders, but not customer shipments or anything that has to do with accounting. The status column is filled in with the default initial status assigned to all new customers, which is potential. To convert a potential customer to a regular customer, we'll go to the direct activations and click on the Convert Potential Customer to Customer action. As a result, the customer number becomes a permanent one. On the basis of the numeration template defined in the Customer and Vendor Numeration Templates form, and the status changes to an active one. Additional statuses can be defined and used for different purposes. For example, if the status column is inactive, such a customer does not appear in the choose list of transaction documents. You can also use statuses to define a customer as restricted or under warning of restriction, resulting in warning messages when the customer is recorded in various documents. In the Address and Phone tab, we can fill in the customer's address, city, postal code, country, phone number, fax, email, and website. Pressing F6 or the Explorer icon from this column when there is data in it will open a web browser directly to the customer's website. In the Details tab, we can link the customer to a sales rep who will appear by default in any of the customer's documents. We can also flag the Change Name column, which allows us to change the customer's name in various documents, particularly useful for a walk-in customer. In the Company Data tab, we can fill in additional data such as the customer's company number, customer group, and type of business. Additional data regarding this customer can be found in various tabs such as the shipment, payment, categories, etc. Additional data regarding the financial parameters for a customer can be defined in the financial parameters for customers form. So we're going to go to that form now, and as you can see, the default here, the currency default is dollars, but we can record receipts and invoices in different currencies, and each journal entry will also display the transaction value in the customer's account currency. In the Customer tab, we can define the customer's regular payment terms. Here are a number of default options. Special payment terms can be defined in individual documents when necessary. In the Billing Customer Number column, we can select another customer whose account would be used to process the customer's payments. In the Invoices tab, you can define various parameters such as price rounding for this customer. Pressing F1 on these or any of the columns opens a help window describing the column's functionality. In the Credit tab, we can define the customer's credit limits. If a given transaction causes the customer to exceed these limits, a warning or error message is received according to the value defined for the credit message financials constraint. Enter the customer credit sublevel form and view the customer's credit balances broken down by document type. And in the bank account details sublevel form, you can define the details that will appear by default when you open a bank transfer for this customer. There are many other sublevel forms, and you can right click on any of the sublevel form titles to receive a definition of what that sublevel form is about. Let's return to the customer form. Let's return to the customer form. Here in the sublevel forms for the customer, we have different options for defining marketing campaigns, customer parts, special prices, discounts, etc. Let's take one example and look at the customer contacts. We can either look at the customer contacts in single record form or multi-record form. We're going to click F4 and get to single record. Here we can put an email address in. We can put information regarding the person's job title, profession, personal details, and then flag them as what type of contact they are and what documents they will receive. For more information on customers, run the Open Customers Wizard. For more information about customer prices and discounts, run the Prices and Discounts Wizard.